Meanwhile, no doubt you're hearing the words cure and curing in connection with other states' presidential vote counts.
It happens every election cycle in every state, and the goals are the same. Reporter Larry Seward asked experts to break it all down for us.
Curing is the way laws let voters fix mistakes on absentee and provisional ballots. All states allow it, rules vary, but this much is standard. The only information states let you fix involves identification and verifying valid voter status. Counters red flag things like missing signatures, printed names, addresses, dates of birth, identification numbers, and changes that do not match county records.
If any of those items are missing, we cannot process the ballot. So we will send you what is called an 11S form, and that's how you cure your ballot.
Ohio gives voters phone call warnings, fix-it forms, and up to 10 days after election night to cure problems. Staffs get the same amount of time to vet provisional ballots, which involve in-person voters whose eligibility was challenged at the polls. In June, Kentucky launched its first ever cure process that ends Monday. 3 months ago, nonpartisan watchdogs in Indiana won a court battle after several counties rejected ballots without telling voters. A federal judge ruled the practice, quote, violates due process and equal protection rights.
Be aware that your signature is going to be compared with another signature that the election office has on hand. And in some cases, that signature can go back to the first time you registered to vote at 18.
Statewide, Ohio tossed 10,000 provisional ballots in April's primary. Most involved people not registered, registered in the wrong state, missing IDs, or they voted too late. Deciding voter intent is not part of the curing process, but could become a factor in any recount.
Most of the time, honestly, I would tell you 90% of the time, you can tell what the voter's intent was.
Ohio and Kentucky counties own sensitive scanners for paper ballots engineered to catch mismarks.
They're very accurate, so there should be no worry for the voter whatsoever.
But physical recounts, which are not expected here, require election boards to look at each questionable vote and decide what the voter meant. In some places, boards examine just a sampling of ballots by hand to compare with electronic results. All of this has to happen before final reporting deadlines, unless a court order says otherwise. Larry Seward, WCPO 9 News.